Today on the Happi House, presented by Creative Kid Stuff.
Crafts that make beautiful Mother's Day gifts.
Yay, that turned out really great. And then,
learn how to make a recipe submitted by one of our viewers. Delicious, crispy peanut butter balls.
And finally,
I'm at Mama's Happi with one of my favorite moms, Amanda. And we are talking about how to make special gifts for the moms in your life.
Stay tuned. Hi, I'm Happi. I learned early on things are much easier with a little help. I also have a few tricks of my own to share. It's go time, people. Welcome to the Happi House, presented by Creative Kid Stuff. Here are three simple and beautiful gifts kids can make for Mother's Day. Chandler, have you ever used a stamp before?
Yes.
Do you know that you can stamp things onto fabric, not just paper?
Yes.
You do know that? You must live with me. Okay, so we are going to actually, Grandma loves dish towels. I love dish towels too. So one really easy, and you ask yourself why?
Who loves dish towels?
I love dish towels. That's how I clean up after you. So we are going to actually just make Grandma a custom dish towel, and it's really easy. Flour sack towel. You need to wash and dry everything in order for the fabric markers to work. Well, you can also stamp 100% cotton pillowcase, but we're gonna do a dish towel today, okay? So I've got two stamps here, Chandler. I've got a bird and I've got these flowers. Which one do you think you want to use on Grandma's towel?
The bird.
The bird. Perfect. Okay, so these are fabric markers. And one tip I learned early on in my fabric stamping career, is that I actually use fabric markers, not ink pads, because you can put the ink exactly where you want it to be. So Chandler, we're going to spread this dish towel out. And we'll just do half at a time. And all you need to do is choose the color you want. Okay. And all you then need to do is color on this bird. Can you do that?
Uh-huh. Yeah. I'm coloring a bird.
All right, coloring a bird. You want to make sure that you do get pen or ink on the entire stamp. All right, you do good. You do good work. I just want to make sure we got this right here because there's nothing worse than going in for the perfect stamp and realizing you don't have enough ink on here. So we have covered the entire stamp with ink, and then Chandler is going to decide where he wants his first bird print to be. Where do you want it to go?
Right there.
Right, okay. Right there. And you are doing a very good job. Make sure to press down firmly on your stamp and wait. All right, ready for the big reveal?
Uh-huh.
Let's see how it looks. Perfect. All right, I'm going to send you over to the table to work on finishing this project up.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm going to show Ella how to make an easy and fun gift. Do you like this little dandelion bookmark?
Yeah.
Yeah? Do you think your mom or other people might like to receive it as a gift?
Yeah, my sister likes flowers and my mom likes reading.
Check, check, right? All right, so let me show you how to do this. It's really easy. Have you ever made a pom-pom before?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, we are going to use a fork to make a pom-pom that makes a dandelion. Are you ready? Okay. All right, the first thing we do is put the green yarn on the fork. That's going to end up being the stem of our dandelion later. I'm going to cut it extra long because we're going to do something with that. And then we are going to wind this yellow yarn around the fork, around and around and around and around. All right, so now I've got that, and I'm gonna take the green yarn that we started with, I'll just move this to the side, and I'm gonna tie a really, really tight knot. Actually, let me cut. First, I'm gonna detach my yellow, and then I am going to tie a knot like so, and it's important that it's tight because that's what makes the pom-poms fuller. We've just finished tying the knot nice and tight. Then I'm going to remove it from the fork and use a scissors to cut the loops. How are you doing so far? Easy?
Pretty darn easy.
This is a fun project. I also like to make pom-poms to tie onto gift tags and give people. All right, so we're gonna trim it up a little bit. Then what we're gonna do is make the base of our pom-pom. So I'm going to gather things up a little bit here. I'm gonna force this in, and I'm gonna start winding this yarn around the base. Okay. And now we're just going to secure the end by tying a knot. And we'll tie a knot at the end so it doesn't slip out of the book. And I'm gonna do a little bit of trimming. But you get the idea. Look at that. All right, do you wanna go make some pom-poms and more of these dandelions at the table?
Okay.
All right. Emerson, we've been working on this really easy candle holder. Let's tell everyone how we did this, and then I'm really excited about the big reveal because we're gonna peel the tape and see the shapes we made. I think these are gonna be really pretty. So what we did first is found a used jar, right? And it can be any jar. And then the next thing is we decided what shape we wanted the clear part of our candle holder to be. So we chose heart and star. This one's a star on here. When we were trying to figure out how to get the shape on here, we had a great idea of using just an old piece of plastic. Like, this came off of some packaging, and we just laid our tape over it. It's very important to use the blue painter's tape so it doesn't stick. Then we cut the shape out and carefully took the tape off of here and applied it on to our jar, and then spray painted it, which is kind of the fun part, right? And we use just any kind of spray paint. So now what I want you to do, are you ready for this? Is to peel this off. I'm gonna hold it for you and let's see how we did. The nice thing is you don't have to worry about getting the tape off all in one piece. You can tear it off in little bits too.
It's going everywhere.
That's all right. You got time. It's a crafternoon, right? All right, let's see. Get it, girl. Oh, I can see the heart starting to take shape. Yay, that turned out really great. The final step is decorating our jar with maybe some pretty string or yarn. What colors do you think we should put on there?
Should we put all of them on there?
We can put all of them on. More is more, girl. Let's do it. Okay, I will go ahead and get those. Thanks for crafting with me, Emerson. We've got a full afternoon of crafting ahead of us. I am excited to see how all of our projects turn out. Up next on the Happi House, I'm with Amanda, and we are making a recipe submitted by one of our viewers. Crispy peanut butter balls. They are delicious. Amanda, I posted a contest on the Happi House Facebook page to entice people to submit their recipes because everybody's got their like secret recipes or their go-to recipes, especially around the holidays.
Right.
And we got quite a few submissions, but there was a winner.
Congratulations, Callie from Appleton, Wisconsin. When we saw this recipe for these decadent peanut butter balls, we knew we had a winner.
So this is a cookie that I have eaten before but never really knew how to make. And it's very, very easy as it turns out.
Okay, good. That's good for me.
So we have this crispy peanut butter ball recipe. And I've gone ahead and made up the dough or the batter, but then you and I are going to finish these cookies off.
Okay.
But basically, it's 2 cups of creamy peanut butter.
Okay.
And then 1/2 cup butter, softened.
Okay.
And then 3 3/4 cup confectioner's sugar, or powdered sugar, as I call it.
Okay.
And then 3 cups of crispy rice cereal.
Okay.
So you combine those ingredients together, and it makes this dough.
Okay.
Which then you refrigerate.
Okay.
And then you roll into balls like this.
Lovely.
I know. They're going to be pretty after we're done, though.
All right.
Then you refrigerate these so they're hard because what's going to happen is we are going to dip them in a melted chocolate to cover them. And then once that sets, we're going to drizzle white chocolate over the top to make it pretty. Yes.
Okay.
So we are at the point now where we can go ahead and melt down our chocolate. So the chocolate chips, we need 4 cups of semi-sweet chocolate chips, 1/4 cup shortening. So I'm guessing she is referring to like lard or, so not butter, not margarine, right, but the white
true
stuff.
True shortening. Yes. Okay.
So we're going to mix this in with the chocolate chips and then microwave it, okay, until it's soft, and then dip these balls, and we're well on our way.
I think I could actually handle this
cooking. I think so too, and I think it's going to be delicious. So I'm going to put this shortening in here and we'll microwave it.
All right.
And get it ready to dip. Our chocolate is nice and melty and does not smell burnt. So we did 145 and then another minute, yep, stirring between. Mm-hmm. Just as kind of a guideline for people. So now comes the fun part. We have our balls here, and I'm gonna put those over here so we can both reach them. And we've got our chocolate, and then this wax-lined cookie sheet. So we can put the finished dipped peanut butter balls on here to harden, and then we'll add the finishing touch.
Okay.
So carefully dip them, and I...
Yes. And you cover the whole thing?
Cover the whole thing.
Without losing it in the chocolate.
Well, that's the goal, Amanda.
Okay.
Woo! Look at that.
Nice. I'm scared, Mike.
We got this.
All right. I love doing this part.
Yeah, it's kind of satisfying, honestly. All right. I love that. I'm kind of thinking these are going to be delicious.
I'm kind of thinking we should have some before the children get home.
I will never get one.
Okay. It wasn't that hard.
It was not hard at all.
Thank you so much for sharing this delicious recipe with us, Callie. Be sure to follow the Happi House on Facebook and Instagram to learn about more contests.
Coming up next, I'm at Mama's Happi with one of my favorite moms, Amanda. We are talking about how to make a special gift for the moms in your life.
We all celebrate Mother's Day with our moms and our mother-in-laws and, of course, our kids. But we know a lot of people who are our friends or just special people to us. So it's important to remember them around, mm-hmm, Mother's Day, too, because us moms, we're in it together. Right, Amanda?
Right, right. We absolutely are.
We are going to talk about fun and easy jewelry that you can make to give as a gift.
Okay.
To special people in your life, right?
Yes. So what I love to do is just kind of collect. You can either buy these kind of things. Sometimes I like to use found objects. One of my favorite go-tos are the Scrabble tiles, just because everybody loves a letter, right?
Yes.
Whether it's your initial or your children's initials. So I've just kind of gathered some of those things here. You know, it'd be fun to get together with girlfriends and make these for each other or make something for your mom.
If you do have girlfriends over, have everybody bring something, yeah, and create like a hodgepodge and sort of do a swap meet.
Yep.
Do a swap meet.
Yep.
So,
I love that.
Okay. So I notice we have some eye hooks in, yes, our Scrabble tiles. Do I need a drill or how did you do,
yeah,
this?
Yes. So you either need to have a very tiny drill bit. Look, I found you an H. Or you can use a tiny, tiny nail to get started. And all you're going to do is just barely tap that in there to get the hole started. And then your eye hook will screw right in there.
Okay.
So the key is very gently, and you don't have to hammer it very far.
These Scrabble tiles are wood, whereas, mm-hmm, I have felt some before that are the
plastic
or the resin.
Right.
So, all right.
You want to get the old wooden ones.
Okay. So I've started the hole here.
Okay. And then you're just going to pick up your little eye hook
and screw
that right in there. And the eye hooks come in different finishes too, so you want to think about what color chain you're going to be using, then that'll help you decide,
okay,
what finish you want on your, yeah, your eye hook.
Oh, this is easy. Okay, so that is in there.
Perfect.
So that is...
Nicely done. Okay.
Awesome. All right, so I've got these charms, and I like this chain. I like the patina of it. Mm-hmm. It's just kind of not a bright silver. It's sort of muted. So I think my bigger charms will fit over here, over this.
Yeah, yeah.
But this guy is not going to.
No.
So what I'm going to need to do now is actually put a jump ring on here. And so I'm going to twist it flat like that.
Yep.
And then use these pliers to twist open my jump ring. Let's see here. This is kind of fussy work sometimes. What are you going to make, Amanda?
Well, I'm kind of watching what you're doing to help decide what I want to do.
Okay.
I love using this gravel tile, so I know I'll use that and decide if my mom would wear a scrabble tile.
I'm practicing before I actually make something to give to someone else.
That's a good idea. That's actually a very good idea.
We talked about having ladies over. You could actually have people over, and the idea is to make something for yourself that you know you would wear and enjoy having. All right, so Amanda, we are both moms. What's your favorite part about being a mom?
Well, I have to say, when my kids were young, that was not my strongest time. I struggled.
Really?
When they were little, I just struggled. So now that my youngest is 10, so I feel like now I'm really getting to see the kind of people that they are,
yeah,
you know, becoming, and I enjoy them. I really enjoy them.
It's fun to have a real conversation with your kids.
Yes. Yeah. It is. Mm-hmm. So those mothers of young kids out there, don't give up.
Right?
Don't give up. No. It gets better.
How about with your own mom? What do you remember about?
Well, I think the thing that sums up my mom the best is that she was a stay-at-home mom. Mm-hmm. And I just remember her in the mornings when it would snow. She would be anxiously waiting, hoping that they canceled school. Hoping that they canceled school.
Yes.
And I remember hearing friends whose moms had to work, or they had to come up with other plans for them if it was a snow day. And I just remember thinking, that's so awesome that my mom actually would love to have us be home. And I can remember thinking that. I want to be the kind of mom that gets excited for a snow day.
There is something really special about a snow day.
Yeah.
Because you can't go anywhere. You can't do... All bets are off.
That's right.
And you just have to kind of lean in. Mm-hmm. Right?
Yeah.
What are you making over there?
Well, I kind of thought... So my sisters are Blakeney and Chandler. So without knowing it, my mom named us A, B, and C. Amanda Blakeney Chandler. Isn't that funny? So
yeah.
I thought, well, maybe I would do a necklace for her.
Are you the oldest?
Three. I am the oldest.
That seems great. So what are you going to do with these tiles?
So I'm thinking maybe I will do, instead of doing a necklace, my mom is more of a bracelet person. So I love... This is just leather cording that you can, again, buy at any craft store.
Mm-hmm.
And so the style will be that it's kind of wrapped around...
I love wrap bracelets.
I do too. I like, they kind of can be, you know, just good casual with jeans.
Yeah.
And so for that style, we're going to put an eye hook on both ends. So, or I guess I could even do it both sides and have it lay this way.
Oh yeah.
ABC. And I love that everybody will just think it's ABC,
ABC,
but she'll know. So how about you? Tell me something that you love about being her mom.
I was a good little people mom, so I love babies and just loved the fact that they were dependent on me for so many things. So that was a really special time. But now as my kids get older, it, again, is really interesting seeing what kind of people they're becoming. But even beyond that, the experiences that they're about to have, my daughter is going to go abroad for her first time ever. Without me, she's going to Norway, so that's going to be hard, but also I'm so excited about the opportunities she's going to have. So
You feel both. You're excited for them to spread their wings, and yet...
It's bittersweet. Yeah. This is coming along nicely.
I'm struggling with this one. I don't know. My fingers.
That happens sometimes. I remember when I was little, my mom actually was a working mom. She taught at a beauty academy, so she was a cosmetologist, and... some days, I don't know why or how, but I would get to go to work with her for whatever reason if I didn't have daycare. So then the students, they had a booster chair, would sit me in the chair and practice like braiding my hair and cutting my hair.
That's like a little girl's dream.
I know. And then they also had those hair cutting heads. And so I would get to then practice styling on those myself. And I would always get to pick out a comb to bring home with me. Weird.
Isn't it funny? What you remember
I know. It was really...
I bet all your friends thought your mom had the coolest job of any.
Yeah, one year I got to have my birthday party there, and then we all got to have our hair styled. That was long, I mean, that was probably 38 years ago. That was long before the parties of today that you can actually just, we kind of did our own thing.
Yeah.
So lots of fun.
That's a really great memory.
Oh, this looks great. I love it. So the awesome thing about something like this is, well, I love wrap bracelets, but you can just cut this leather to fit your wrist how you want it to. We can also slide these tiles, if they're not, mm-hmm. so this kind of can be, I don't know, jingly or whatever, but like, so they're not maybe all right next to each mm-hmm. other, so it goes around your wrist a little bit
better.
What do you think?
Whichever one she's...
Yeah. Who's the favorite, Amanda?
Well, there's no question I'm the favorite.
Really?
Yeah. Just kidding, girls. I'm just kidding.
All right, I'm gonna tie this.
My mom is a praying mom, so I can already hear her saying, oh, whichever one of y'all is needing the most prayer. Put you right there.
That's nice. All right, I love this. It's super cute.
It's super cute.
I love how that turned out. And I like how we spaced them because now it's more comfortable.
It is, and so cute.
Yeah. This is even kind of cute as a sister bracelet, too. I mean, you could wear this because you have your twin sisters. So this has been fun. I definitely think we need to get more ladies together and make some things, probably eat some delicious food, and obviously talk and laugh.
Yeah, I think that sounds like a lovely way to spend a day.
Yeah, happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
I love you, Mom.
I love you, Mom.
Love you, Mom. Okay, all right, it's I, because we don't have the same mom. Last time I checked.